our hearts, O Lord, to listen to the words of your Son.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too, go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off. And he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more, but each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last." My friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Magandang umaga po. Happy Sunday po sa inyong lahat. Could we greet the person beside us? Happy Sunday. Happy Sunday po. Our Gospel today tells us what the kingdom of heaven is. And Jesus used a parable to compare to it to the workers of the vineyard. He used a story. For today, I will use the story in our gospel as our starting point of reflection. And there are three things that we could learn from the parable related to the kingdom of heaven. Three things. First, heaven is for those who are willing to work. Heaven is only for those who are willing to work. So if you do not want to work, heaven is not for you. Malinaw po ba yon? In short, bawal tamad. Bawal po. Kaya kung ayaw mong kumilos, ang langit ay hindi para sa'yo. I'm sorry to say that because that is what we heard in our parable. Like the workers who were called by the vineyard owner from morning to the last hour of the day. All of them worked. Walang hindi nagtrabaho. Kahit pa nung nagsimula ng umaga, nagtrabaho. Kahit nung huli na tinawag, nagtrabaho pa din. Magkakaiba man sila ng oras ng pagtawag, sa huli, lahat nagtrabaho. Lahat kumilos. You know, my dear brothers and sisters, during that time, laborers did not have a steady work or income. Wala, hindi katulad natin ngayon, kailangan ma-regular. Hindi katulad natin ngayon, kahit tatamad-tamad, no? Mag-iisip lang ng paraan, bukas Lunes, lalagnatin yata ako. Meron pa rin sweldo, kasi may sick leave. Uulan yata bukas, uunahan ko na. But during that time, wala. No steady work, no steady income. That is why nothing will happen if you will not work. Walang mangyayari sa'yo kung hindi ka magtatrabaho. So they have to work on a day-to-day basis, every day. Hindi pwede yung nag-work na ako last week, leave naman ako next week. Deserve ko naman ito. Yeah, ganyan tayo eh. No? Maka-deserve. No? But during Jesus' time, they have to work every day. From which, they will get their pay. No work, no pay. No one goes to heaven by doing nothing. Wala po itong iniwan sa mga pangarap natin. Kung ayaw mong pagtrabahuan, huwag mong asahan na ito ay iyong makakamtan. Bar exam po ngayon, no? May mga nagte-text po, no, sa akin, no? Father, please pray for my son or daughter. Please pray, magba-bar exam po ako ngayon. May bar po. So, you have to work for it. You cannot only ask for it. Ang pangarap, hindi yan nasa isip. Tinatrabaho para mangyari. Same as marriage. If you want your marriage to prosper, work for it. Same with graduation. You have to work for it. With a good life, you have to work for it. Kaya, work po tayo. Opo. Bawal ang tamad. Because heaven is for those who are willing to work. That's one. Second, heaven is for the righteous. Ang langit ay para sa mga matutuwid. Like the owner of the vineyard who never cheats and gives what is just to the laborers, which is the day's wage. Walang puwang sa langit ang may ugaling pangit. Nulit ko po, ugali po yung pangit. Walang puwang sa langit ang may ugaling pangit. Kaya hindi pwede kahit na ang ugaling inggit. Katulad nung mga trabahador, na unang tinawag, sa halip na magpasalamat sa tinanggap, nakatingin sa tinanggap ng iba. Why did they complain? Because they were not looking at what they received. They look at what others received. They compare from others. That's why they failed to be grateful. This is the reason why people become ungrateful. For they do not look what has been given to them. Instead, they look at what has not been given them. Hindi nakikita kung ano ang ibinigay, kundi kung ano ang hindi ibinigay. Oh, bakit ba ganun tayo? Bakit ganun? Oh, tinitingnan natin, ba't naman siya isang take lang ng exam, nakapasa na. Ako, naka-apat na. Hindi mo man lang pagbigyan, Lord. Bakit siya maganda ang buhay? Ako, hindi. You cannot question that eh. It's so hard to question that. Because of number three. Number three is, heaven is a gift from God. That's why you cannot question it. Whether we like it or not, heaven is still a gift. It must be given, not asked. Sadya po, may mga bagay na hindi mo pwedeng hingin. Pwede mong pagtrabahuan, pero depende pa din kung ito ay ibibigay. The minimum that we could do is to work for it. But because it is a gift, all the more it becomes special. Hindi mo pwedeng hingin ng graduation. Hindi mo pwedeng hingin ng bar exam. Hindi mo pwedeng hingin ang magandang pagsasama o magandang kasal. It is a gift. You can only work for it. Kahit ginawa mo ng lahat, we still hope that it would be given. Because heaven is a gift from God. And this is where the generosity of the owner comes. Despite the last hour of the day, he still called those who did not have work. Kaya nga, regalo, dahil ibinibigay bukal sa kalooban. In giving gift, there is always an element of generosity. Siguro, kung iba lang yon, kung hindi yung owner ng vineyard, hindi siya tatawag ng magtatrabaho pa sa huli na. Sayang eh. Isang oras na lang eh. Kung hindi yung may-ari ng vineyard, kung hindi siya generous, hindi na siya tatawag ng iba. Isang oras na lang magtatrabaho, pero babayaran mo pa rin. Bukas mo na tatawagin ng maaga. But the owner of the vineyard is generous because that is his heart. And no one can question that. Kaya nga ang pinapaalala ni Propeta Isaiah sa ating unang pagbasa, what the Lord said, "My thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways." Ang isip ng Diyos ay hindi natin kaisipan at magkaiba ang ating daan. We cannot question God, especially when He is giving gift. We can only be grateful. We can only look at our own giftedness. My dear brothers and sisters, this is what heaven is. It is for those who are willing to work. It is for the righteous. And most especially, it is a gift from God. That is why heaven is not only a destination. So do not presume that when you die, you will go to heaven because that is your destination. No, you have to work for it. It is not a destination, but our desired intention. our desired intention. So you have to be good. And most especially, with God's intervention. It is a gift from God. Again, heaven is not only a destination, but a desired intention with God's intervention. Amen.